Hi everyone, this is Teacher Jane of Teach Talk, where learning is fun and easy. If this is your first time watching our videos, don't forget to subscribe and click that bell button so you'll get notified on our next videos. Welcome to Shenshi Amazing! Shenshi Amazing! Kung saan pag-uusapan natin ang science concepts from grade 7 to grade 12, including topics in general science, biology, chemistry, physics, and earth science. At dito, bidang agham. Our Shenshi Amazing episode for today will be all about the biotic components of an ecosystem. The biotic part of the ecosystem pertains to all the living things. Merong three major groups ang biotic components ng ecosystem. First, we have the producers, consumers, and decomposers. Ang mga producers ay mga organisms na kayang mag-manufacture o mag-make ng kanilang own food. They are also known as autotrophs. The main producers ng ating ecosystem ay ang mga chlorophyll-bearing na organisms just like plants. Plants can photosynthesize. Ano ba ang photosynthesis? In its simplest nature, the photosynthesis is the process kung saan ang sunlight, carbon dioxide, at water ay ginagamit ng plant in order to produce sugars, and also oxygen as its byproduct. A sugar is a type of carbohydrate. Ano ang carbohydrate? Mahalaga ba ito? The answer is yes. Carbohydrates are the main source of energy of our body, and they are the building blocks kung saan ginagawa ang ibang nutrients kagaya ng proteins and fats. Examples of food-rich in carbohydrates are potatoes, bananas, bread, and corn. Aside from plants, meron din tayong green algae, which is capable of photosynthesizing to produce sugar and oxygen. And in fact, these green algae are responsible for the most amount of oxygen in our atmosphere. Aside from those, we also have photosynthetic bacteria, which can also photosynthesize. An example of this are these cyanobacteria. Cyanobacteria is a group of bacteria living in moist soils and water which contribute to the environment through photosynthesis. Plants, green algae, and photosynthetic bacteria are all producers because they are able to photosynthesize. However, meron din tayong producers na hindi photosynthesis ang mechanism. Instead, they are chemosynthetic. For example, we have chemosynthetic bacteria, which undergoes chemosynthesis, just like the methanogens, which produce methane from carbon dioxide and hydrogen in oxygen-poor conditions. In the picture, we can see an archaea, Methanobrevibacter smithii, the one which is orange in color. Our second major group of living things are the consumers, which cannot make their own food and therefore dumidepende sila sa ibang organisms for food. They either eat or they feed on other animals. They are also called heterotrophs. Based on their size, consumers can be macro-consumers or micro-consumers. Macro-consumers are the large consumers. Micro-consumers are the small consumers. Let's explore macroconsumers, which has three groups which are very, very familiar to us. We have the herbivores, carnivores, and omnivores. Let's start with herbivores. Ang mga plant eaters or herbivores ay ang mga animals na kumakain ng plant lamang. Ang mga halimbawa ay horse, carabao, and goat. Ang mga flesh eaters or carnivores ay mga animals that feed only on animals. Halimbawa ay ang Philippine eagle. Their diet includes monkeys, birds, foxes, and giant cloud rats. Meron din tayong snakes and hawks. Let's have another trivia! Alam niyo ba na meron tayong way para ma-distinguish ang herbivores at carnivores? Yes, meron! It's through their teeth. Ang mga herbivores or plant eaters ay merong chisel-like incisors which are large. For example, this goat, kapag isi-zoom natin, its teeth actually look like this. They are flat and they are large in order to chew plants effectively. Habang ang mga carnivores naman, ang mga flesh eaters, ay merong long, sharp front teeth to help them catch and tear into their prey. Maninipis ang kanilang mga ngipin and they are very sharp, just like knives. They are structured para ishred ang mga animals na kinakain nila. How about humans? Bakit ganito ang structure ng ngipin natin? We have 8 incisors, 4 canines, 8 premolars, 12 molars kasama ang wisdom teeth. The reason kaya marami tayong types ng teeth is that we are omnivores. Ibig sabihin, we eat both plants and meat. Aside from eating, our teeth also helps us to speak. So make sure to take care of your teeth by brushing every day. Going back, punta naman tayo sa mga mixed eaters o sa mga omnivores. Omnivores are higher level consumers that feed on both plants and animals. Examples include rat, chicken, and us humans. Then we have our third and last group of living things. We have the decomposers. Decomposers are also called microconsumers because most of them are too small for our eye to see. Aside from microconsumers, they are also called saprotrophs because they feed on dead organic matter. Another name to call this group is final consumers kasi they break down complex substances into simpler substances na magagamit muli ng mga producers. Common examples of decomposers are the fungi, which are almost everywhere, and the primary decomposers in many ecosystems. We also have the microscopic bacteria. Mahalaga ang mga organisms na ito para ma-recycle ang mga minerals sa ecosystem upang magamit silang muli ng mga producers na kakainin ng consumers at i-decompose ulit ng mga decomposers. And the cycle goes on and on. Before we have a quiz, let's have a quick recap first. In our Shensha Amazing episode, we discussed about the biotic components of the ecosystem, including the producers, consumers, groups of consumers, some teeth trivia, and lastly, all about the decomposers. It's quiz time! I will give you 3 minutes to answer this short quiz. And after 3 minutes, we will check if you really learned something from this video. Time's up! Let's answer number one. Decomposers are also called blank because they feed on dead organisms. Ano ang isang tawag sa mga decomposers? They are also called saprotrophs. Number two, these are flesh eaters like snakes and hawks. Saan dito ang kumakain ng other animals? We have carnivores. Number three, they depend on other animals for food. Ibig sabihin, they cannot make their own food. These are heterotrophs. Number four, they produce their own food from inorganic materials. Example of a food-making process is photosynthesis. Anong tawag sa group ng mga organisms na ito? They are called autotrophs. Number five, they have flat and chisel-like teeth to chew plants. Sa mga natitirang choices, saan dito ang kumakain ng plants? We have, obviously, herbivores. That ends our quiz. Please comment your score over 5 so that we can see how much you have learned in our video. That ends our Shensha Amazing episode for today. Don't forget to subscribe, like, and share this video to your friends so that we can learn together. Bye!